So thank you very much for the invitation to this conference. And I will talk about a joint work with Andreas Langer. And it is about the deformation theory of hyperkähler varieties from the point of view of displays. So, and I mean hyperkähler varieties were considered recently by several people, for example Charles, and these are higher dimensional varieties which are very close to K3 surfaces in their properties, and studying this owes much to two articles of Deline wrote down by Elusy in a lecture note, Surface Algebrique, in an old lecture note. And so let me recall what is a frame. It consists of a ring W, an ideal J in this ring, and R is a quotient. And there are two maps. So one map, sigma, is an endomorphism of this ring W, and a sigma point is a map from J to R to W, which is sigma linear. And it has a property that the image generates W as an, so the image sigma W generates the unit ideal in W. So generates W as an ideal. And moreover, if we consider a sigma, okay, I mean I fix now a prime number P which is bigger or equal to 3, but this P will all the times become bigger during the talk. Yeah. And
what is sigma? Sigma is any.
Sigma is any endomorphism. I mean, this is only the general framework, but I explain then examples. So these rings will W and R will be p-adic rings. Often P will be nilpotent even. And sigma modulo P will be the absolute Frobenius. Sigma x modulo P will be x to the power P, where x is an element in W. So, and we consider two types of frames here. One is we start with a p-adic ring, and we take a WR, which is then also a p-adic ring, and and here we have the ideal J is equal to the Verschiebung of WR. And then sigma will be the Frobenius on the Witt ring, on the ring of Witt vectors, and sigma point of Vxi will be equal to Xi, where Xi is an element of WR. So this is one example, and this frame this frame is called WR. And also we consider S2R with an and the kernel is an ideal A, and we assume that this is endowed with a divided power structure. And then we have a WA, and okay. Excuse me. Yeah, this is a PD, and A is a PD ideal. Yeah. Excuse me. So and then we have a WA, and here we have the Witt polynomials, which are WN, which are map. So if we take the product over the Witt polynomials, we get a map to the product of A, which is of course sometimes zero, but now because we have divided powers, we are allowed to divide these in the sense of divided powers by P to the N, and then this here becomes an isomorphism of abelian groups and even of WS modules. And where of course here I had to say what WS here means, but it means that on the nth component, WS acts via the Witt polynomial. So, and so here we have
this product is in x by n. So this is a countable product, yes?
Yeah, it's a product here is indexed by n.
The product is indexed by n, and here also for all n bigger than zero. This becomes an isomorphism, and here we have the set of all elements. A 0, 0, which we call the logarithmic Teichmüller of of A. So this is an ideal in WS, which is isomorphic to A as an WS module. And
so the map is defined, but you have the PD structure?
It depends on the PD structure, of course.
So you know that this is stable, usually this is not stable under addition. This A000.
Yeah.
When you add two things like this, you get cross terms.
I mean, this is not a Witt vector, of course. I mean, if I write this as a Witt vector.
Ah, yeah, it's this side, it's a element of this product.
Of course, if I write it as a Witt vector, this set has infinitely many components, maybe, yeah. And, and then we. This, I call it A tilde.
It's equal, not
contained. Equal. It's equal. So, and then I have here the map to R, which is a map W0 to S to R. Yeah. And the kernel of this map, J, turns out as a direct sum of A tilde plus the ideal WS. And this ideal, so this is an orthogonal decomposition, so if we multiply two elements here, it is zero, and this ideal has then also divided powers, because on the Witt ring we have here divided powers, and here we have the divided powers. we already had. So this is also a frame. So the Frobenius is as before, is a Frobenius on the ring of Witt vectors and a sigma point of A tilde plus is equal to Xi. So this sigma point just annihilates the ideal A. And this gives another frame, W SR. And so if we have a p-adic ring,
Okay.
I mean, it means a ring which is complete and separated from the p-adic topology. And and then we have X is a X over R is a proper smooth formal scheme. Say first for the p-adic topology, but maybe for some other topology.
The morphism is
what?
The morphism from X to R is adic, if you wanted to, otherwise.
P is an ideal definition.
Yes, of X.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe not always, yeah. For example, yeah.
It's a little bit problematic.
What?
Then smooth, what do you mean by smooth?
Okay, by me, by this I mean this Xn R pi n is smooth for any n. Yeah?
That's a good topology.
Yeah. Okay, but man, sometimes I also consider this here. So I have some other adic topology. Yeah?
Okay, but the morphism is adic. It means if you change topology down, you change it also up.
Yeah. Good. Okay. Yeah, it's adic, yeah. And then I say I have a lifting X tilde over WR, and then with the following properties, if I consider so a lifting as a formal scheme, and I consider the Dram cohomology, then I will assume that this here is locally free so if I take this as a A1 spectral sequence EJ, this should degenerate. And then if I consider so assume R, if R has no P torsion.
But in general, for the finiteness theorems for formal scheme, usually one needs the ring to be Noetherian. Is it here maybe?
Yeah, okay, the ring, you are right, the ring is Noether, so it will be always. Okay, and if it has no p-torsion, then we have this cohomology X over WR, this is for n smaller than P, this is a display. Let me recall what this means. So, first of all, I mean, a display, this means that we have here, for it's a display for the frame WRR. Yeah, and so first of all, a display consists display over F, yeah, or pre-display. Yeah. It consists of a series of W module homomorphisms. And this here, this will be then the in the example, this will be the crystalline cohomology of X over WR in some degree n, yeah. And also it consists of maps from J pi I to pi I plus one. And of sigma linear maps Fi from pi to pi zero, where Fi is a series of sigma linear maps. So this here is linear, and this is sigma linear. And we have that f I plus 1 of alpha c eta. Yeah. If eta is an element of j, x is the same thing as sigma point eta f I of x. So this equation.
Slightly more general than in the definition in your book, or it's equivalent? Because in your book, there is just two things.
Yeah, okay. I defined this place for p-divisible groups, but... now if we want to consider higher cohomology groups, we need higher displays, exactly. And then, so there, I could add more axioms, but this is not absolutely necessary, because so that these data, they should arise from standard data, yeah. So display. The standard. standard datum means just we have modules LD, these are W modules. which are finitely generated projective. And we have a map phi. We have maps phi I from L I to the direct sum LD, and this module will become P0, so we define it now as P0, so and if we take the direct sum of this, we denote it by phi, it gives, so this is sigma linear. It gives a sigma linear endomorphism of P0, and this should be an automorphism. And so for example, if this modules are free, then this then this phi is may be regarded as a block matrix in GLW, yeah? So more or less you can say a display is a block matrix in GLW. But we have to, so then for example, we call Pi plus 1 as J Li plus 1, a J L 0. And then we have here Pi. And here we have the map iota, yeah, iota I. And it is here, it is a multiplication by P, yeah. And here we have Li. So here is always a multiplication by P, but here is an inclusion, and here is the identity. Yeah. And also we have a G tensor. we have G tensor Pi. G tensor. And so on. And here we have the maps alpha to pi I plus 1, which is a JLI. And now we have to distinguish. So if we are, for example, in the case, so this is first for the case WR, yeah. So and then this map here is if I have V psi tensor V eta, the Verschiebung of eta, yeah, times some element of x, it goes here to v xi eta x, yeah. So this map is called the Verjüngung. And here, excuse me. Here, yeah?
Because you go from 0 to I?
So L0, yeah. I gave.
Okay.
So, and but I don't multiply, but I multiply and I do it like this, yeah.
V is
Yeah, so this I usually call the Verjüngung. Yeah, which is a word from tensor. From tensor algebra in Germany. So if you take a tensor, then you can take the trace with respect to a covariant and a contravariant index. This you call in Germany the Verjüngung. Okay, and here you take this also, and here you have JLI, LI plus 1. And here you just have the inclusion, yeah? And then in the end you have the Frobenius. Yeah? So if you have here PI, then you have GL0, yeah? And here you have the map 2P0, yeah? But you don't take this map, but you take the map phi zero tilde, yeah? Where phi zero tilde of v xi x is c phi zero x. And so on, yeah? G L I minus 1 phi I minus 1 tilde 2P0. And then you have here L I. Here you take phi I. And then you take P times phi I. 2 pi 0 and so on, yeah? And then you get a pre-display, yeah? So then this is a pre-display, and a display is a pre-display which is isomorphic to a standard one. So with this definition, so we get pi I iota I alpha I fi. So this is a standard construction. Yeah? This is our construction. And a display is a pre-display which comes from this standard construction. Obtained, or which is isomorphic to this, say, the star from the construction star, yeah?
This construction sheafifies well. So if you have sheaves, it means locally it comes from, or it's...
No, global. Yeah, I mean, in the applications we have always local rings and so on. Maybe you should make this definition more general, but now for this purpose it's sufficient to do it like this. And okay, we could also give a definition without referring to the LIs, but this is more complicated. But for example, if R is a perfect field K, yeah, then a display is the same thing as as a module P0 with a Frobenius. So this from P0 to P0, which is which is injective. Yeah, and so so an effective isocrystal. A display over K is the same thing as an effective isocrystal. Yeah, because you
you don't need pin vertible, right?
No, no, no. So it is effect. Yeah, okay. It is a Frobenius module. Yeah, a module with a Frobenius. So you consider P zero, and then you have here F to the minus one P zero, and then by the elementary divisor theorem, this is a direct sum of L to LD, such that this here is L0 direct sum P to the minus 1 L1 P to the minus D LD. Yeah, you can find such modules, and then you make out of these modules a display, and this is an equivalence of categories. It is. So if you are over a perfect field, there is no difference between these two notions. But so this is this notion is made to study the crystalline cohomology relative to a ring which has nilpotent elements. Yeah. So over an Artin ring, for example. I mean, we have also displays for WS over R. Then we have then we have here some other ideals, yeah. So where JI is the ideal AI plus EW of S. And we also have the Verjüngung, which is a map from J times J to J. Which is new of A tilde V xi. Tensor B tilde plus B eta is equal to A tilde times B tilde plus V xi eta. And we have also the map pi of A tilde plus V xi. And it is equal to A tilde plus P V xi. And then you have to replace this P here by pi. Then you get what is called a WS over R display. Excuse me, W.
explain that it's a display, you need the assumption of the generation of the
spectrum. Yeah. Because if this is not the case, then the display structure should be on the complex in the derived category. And I didn't make such a definition. First, I have to see that this definition works in some reasonable sense. Okay. And so we think that in general, if we have X over R, say R, smooth and proper. And now say R. In our case, R will be a local RT in ring. This X has suitable lifting properties. Yeah? So then we would like that to X we associate PS. A W S over R display for each S to R as before, yeah? So, and this should be a crystal in this place. So for this one has to say if we have such a commutative diagram, yeah, P nie potent in R, but we will also use it sometimes for other things. So if we have such a diagram here, of PD extensions, then we have a base change from WS over R dash displays into W S over R displays. Yeah, which goes like if you have here a standard data LI, then the standard data goes to WS tensor WS dash LI. Yeah. So if here you have a display which is here defined by a standard data LI, the base change will be defined by this standard data. Yeah?
Here it will depend on integer
n,
hn, something.
What?
It's associated to some
commutative. Yeah, it's associated to x. For if you have a variety x over r, you have for any PD extension a relative display.
What is related to hn of x in some sense, or what?
Okay, I mean, if you have... if you have, for example, PS, yeah, which is here PIS, yeah, then the P0S will be the crystalline cohomology of X over WS.
So you choose a degree for the crystalline cohomology?
Some degree, the sum of all degrees, or some degree
n? Yeah, okay, we fix some degree n, yeah. Yeah. Excuse me, so this is here HN Chris. It comes in with a display structure. And then.
So here you don't assume any behavior like before of the locally free and degenerate. No.
No lifting?
Yeah, okay, you need such a lifting, yeah. So, I mean, in fact, you need any frame over R which is P torsion free and where this X has a lifting in this frame to W where the spectral sequence degenerates. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In fact, the display itself has some crystalline nature. So in some sense it can fit also in the picture itself. Because you are fixing a frame and so
yeah, we will now see examples where this holds, yeah? So the first example is the theorem of Eike Lau. Yeah? So this PS exists for abelian varieties. Maybe it should be not too difficult to prove this conjecture, but I'm not so far. So and now, now say P is a two display. Also, I have to say something else. So if we have an Artin ring R, yeah, and then we have not only WR. But we have also the small width frame, W hat R, yeah? And the small width frame, it is like this. You have here the ring W hat R, and you have a surjective map to W, so R is, say, R is Artinian. And R by M is a perfect field K, yeah? Well, then you have, this is here contained in WR, and here you have W hat M, WM, and these are the bit vectors which have only finitely many non-zero components. So it turns out this is an ideal in WR. And then you can form this as a small bit ring. And you can.
And you add two vectors which have only finitely many non-zero components, and not necessarily the sum is not like that.
Yeah, if you take the sum here of the two.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, this holds, yeah. That's,
okay, so then, no, I'm not sure I understand.
Okay.
Okay, in any case, this ring here exists. I don't want to discuss it now, yeah.
Okay, it depends on the assumptions on R.
It depends on the assumption, of course, as M. So M is nilpotent. M need to be a nilpotent ideal, yeah.
Okay.
But if M is zero, this is the same ring as W of R, right?
Yeah, of course, yeah. Then it is the same ring as W of K, yeah. So, in fact, this here has a canonical splitting. We have a canonical splitting, and this ring is the semi-direct product of these two. And I mean, we have also. I mean, we can, if we want, we can also consider displays over these rings. These are also p-adic rings. You can also make displays over these rings from varieties. So what is that? For example, we have a variety x0 over a perfect field K, then we say it's ordinary if f from H to I consider in the moment x H2. Is a Frobenius, the Frobenius, Frobenius is an isomorphism. Yeah. So if we have a deformation X over R, yeah, and so this is a usual Frobenius of this.
No, but there is an usual definition of ordinary varieties. Okay.
Yeah, okay, okay, this is true, but here I consider only this Weaker condition, yeah. For example, for K3 surfaces, this is equivalent, yeah, to this other notion. And then, yeah. Then I take the two display, yeah, P. And then I call it ordinary. If x0 is ordinary. And then, then I mean, this here is a two display, yeah? So P comes from a standard data with only three modules, yeah? It's a two display, and so it is given by a matrix, yeah? By a block matrix, so phi. This phi may be written as a block matrix, yeah. And And ordinary, in our sense, means that this is invertible. And so I could I have the following theorem. We have the following theorem. So P an ordinary 2 display relative to WR over WR. And the dual is also ordinary. I mean, I should say that that the displays form a tensor category which has duals, which has all operations of linear algebra. But we can also consider the inverse matrix, and then we can also write it in a block matrix. So the dual is ordinary means that this matrix is invertible. If I have S over R, and a PD, and then I have the base change. Yeah, and so here I have P, and if P1 and P2 are WSR displays. Lifting P, then there is a unique isomorphism between pi 1 and pi 2. Canonically isomorphic. So there's canonically isomorphic. Yeah. So in this case, automatically, if we have this a display, it already is a crystal automatically. We need no.
Why you need this base change of displays? So the displays are of WS or R?
Yeah, here I have a display WS over R, and here I have a display over R, and here is a base change. I mean,
P1 and P2 are what? WS over R displays.
Yeah, P is a WR display.
Ah, OK.
Yeah, I have a WR display and I have this base change functor. I can ask myself whether I have here relative displays lifting P. Of course, I have this because a display is simply a matrix. Of course, I can, because this is nilpotent, the kernel is nilpotent, any invertible matrix lifts, of course, to invertible matrix here, and gives me here a relative display, but these two are canonically isomorphic. And also, yeah, now I have not much time. Now I can consider X hyperkähler. Yeah, and and so if I have, for example, X over R smooth, then hyperkähler means that that if I consider X of the tangent bundle X over R zero and H2 X of the tangent bundle X over R zero and also there is a form omega in X over R which does not vanish in any point, nowhere vanishing. So which defines nowhere vanishing. And H. So this is a symplectic form on this manifold. H2, H0 omega 2 is equal to R. Yeah, so. What?
The differential of omega is zero?
The differential of omega.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. The differential of omega is zero. I mean, it is not in the in the definition, but maybe it follows. And also, it follows then that this TXR is isomorphic to omega XR, which is given by this form omega, yeah, omega one.
Not nowhere vanishing, but everywhere non-degenerate, you mean?
Nowhere degenerate, yeah. And then, if I have x0 over k, is hyperkähler. Yeah. Excuse me. Then to any such X, this is again an Artinian ring. Then the display also every, so the two display. Of X exists, yeah, and so we have the following theorem. So if I have X zero over K, hyperkähler. Then, and X is a deformation, then I can, so X is an element, deformations of X0, yeah, then I can associate to it a display PX, a two display which is self-dual. Yeah? And if X is ordinary, then this is a bijection between the deformations, between deformations of X0 and deformations of P0 to a self-dual. To a self-dual two-display, yeah. So this is a bijection. And
in the ordinary case, you said in the ordinary case.
So if we, of course, we have in the ordinary case also another description of the moduli of the deformation space in terms of the generalized Brouwer group, yeah? So there is an old theorem of Nygaard, but so this display is an extension of the display of the extended Brouwer group and yeah, so you can describe it as an extension class in the category of two displays. And I mean, we have also other deformation theorems, but which are not so, which I cannot describe, which hold in the moment for lack of time, but they hold for any x0, yeah? And I mean, we should remark that if we have WS to WS over R, yeah, we have this base change, then a display here is the same thing as a display here plus a lifting of the Hodge filtration. So, so this display has a Hodge filtration, which comes from the PIs, and so a relative display, if you want to extend it to a display over S, it is the same thing as lifting the Hodge filtration. So, thank you.
Any question?
Yes.
If your base ring R is periodically complete and an integral domain, is there a canonical way to associate Galois representation of the fraction field of R to your display, higher display in the sense?
Yeah, okay, this I don't know. I mean, I know this for one displays, of course. I mean, even if you have say, if you have here a local ring, a complete local ring, yeah, and you have over this a one display, then, and so this is a complete local ring with Galois, with field of fractions k, and then we consider Galois k bar over k. So then. Then to any one display you can associate yeah, okay, but you can describe this directly from the display without going, yeah.
Yeah, this I don't know.
But please, you will go through the composition.
The problem is to construct a tape module for a higher display.
Oh, exactly, and it's not going to work.
I mean,
no, but you have
you don't know how to define a tape module for higher displays. We tried, but so far.
Yeah, okay, no, but the more natural question would be directly. So here you can directly, you can this to a one display. You can directly consider the Galois representation. I mean, by so it, yeah, maybe I cannot describe it in a moment, but it is. Yeah, you have to go to a bigger ring. At a
Question about the deformation here. You consider infinitesimal or formal deformation.
Right? Yeah, so I.
They are ensured by the condition that if 0 and h2 are 0.
Yeah, so then you have.
But my question is in the case of K3 surfaces, of course, you have formal deformation.
Yeah.
On that. Then also line bundles lift. So.
Yeah, okay, you can also have a deformation theory with line bundles, I mean.
Mm-hmm. So what is, I don't remember, the H1 is 0 in this case?
Yeah.
And then you can also imitate somehow the proof for K3.
Yeah, we imitate a lot the linear Elysee. Yeah.
By using term class? And,
Yeah.
And also, since you are in the ordinary case, you get some kind of group structure on the moduli?
Yeah, I mean...
Because you mentioned that the Brouwer group approach of Nygaard, which gives a nice...
Yeah, we should get this, but... But in the moment, I cannot...
You have mechanical lifting first.
Yeah, but it
will
be the origin.
But in some sense, you have here also canonical coordinates, yeah, because this Px is more or less...
Even a group structure, I think.
Yeah. Of course, we know that it exists, yeah. For K3 surfaces, yeah.
But
we haven't generalized.
So I've forgotten a lot.
Yeah. the whole thing, I didn't mention that, is it depends on the Bogomolov-Bouville form. Yeah.
The Bogomolov
one? Bouville form. But I had no time to explain it.
So what is the Bogomolov-Bouville form?
Okay, I mean, if you have here the second, the Rahm cohomology group, yeah?
You have to explain it, because otherwise it's unclear what self-dual means.
Of X, yeah? Of X over R. So, and then you have here a quadratic form to R. And for so in the case of a K3 surface, you take the cup product.
Yes, but here it's any dimension. So.
Yeah, so we have any dimension, but for hyperkähler, you have the Bogomolov-Bouville form, which is given by some integral, and we have generalized the Bogomolov-Bouville form for any arithmetic base, yeah, and this. Bogomolov-Bouville form makes the display self-dual.
Yeah. Depends on the polarization or not?
Yeah, okay, you can look at it. I mean, it is not a polarization because it comes not from a line bundle. For example, if you have the universal deformation, you cannot lift a line bundle to the whole universal deformation. Yeah? I mean, you can also lift it to a sub-variety of some dimension, but...
On some divisor.
So you can, of course, take the form of this divisor, but it exists only over a sub variety, but the Bogomolov-Bouville form exists everywhere. Yeah, so it is given by a formula, but I cannot write it down. Can look the formula.
No, so if those are questions, let's thank our speaker again.